Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see the different representation of binary number, that is mean by signed number and unsigned number. So actually when we enter a number into calculator or computer for the calculation purpose, then we calculate negative number also or we calculate the positive number also. So we have to understand how that negative number and a positive number will be represented in the binary form. Okay, now let us see the hexadecimal number along with its binary representation first. So here we are going to consider only 0 to F hexadecimal digits. Okay, and these are the binary representation of these hexadecimal digits. So how to write this binary format of each and every digit of hexadecimal number system? So starting with the rightmost bit, so right here 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 and so on. Okay, so in the next second right column you have to double the number of zeros and number of ones. Okay, so here write 2 times 0 2 times 1 2 times 0 2 times 1 and so on. Okay, now in the third column double the zeros and ones again. So 4 times 0s 4 times 1 4 times 0s 4 times 1s. Now in the fourth column the number of zeros will be 8 times, and again that is continuous 8 times. Okay, now 8 times 0s and 8 times 1. Okay, so likewise we can represent the binary values of the equivalent hexadecimal digits. Okay, now we know the number line and we have learned in school days, right? So number line you know very well. So first of all we will see the unsigned binary representation. Totally we are having 16 values, that is 0 to 15 or 0 to F you can say, right? Now in this you have to just focus on the leftmost bit is what? This is the fourth bit from right side. Okay, here, so I will just name it here. This bit I will call as D0 bit, this bit I will call D1, this is D2 and D3. Okay, so I am talking about the D3 bit. Okay, so whenever you want to represent any value, any positive value, always positive value, then in that case you need not to mention the sign. For example, rupees. So we don't say like minus 5 rupees, minus 10 rupees like this. So the rupees is not having any unit. Okay, like a quantity. Quantity is also not having any unit. 1 liter, 2 liter like this we can say. Now here, if you want to measure unsigned the quantity, so in that way, in that case, we don't use any sign. So that particular number will be considered as always unsigned, that is the number which is not having any sign, right? So here all these 4 bits will be considered as a number, or it is these four bits are used to represent a number. So actually the bit means binary digit. So BI, BY and P. So this bit is represented as binary digit. So I will say this 1 1 1 1, these are the four, this is the 4 digit value. Okay, 4 digit binary value. Now so here if you are using unsigned binary value, okay, you want unsigned binary value, so in that case you will use all these 4 bits to represent a value. Okay, so that's why the range will start from 0 and it will end with 15 or F in hexadecimal. Okay, now how to represent the signed binary? The signed binary is represented by again the same 4 bit value, but the leftmost bit, that is called MSB, most significant bit. Okay, MSB most significant bit. So most significant bit is what? D3, and least significant bit. So here least significant bit is D0. This is LSB and D3 is MSB. Okay, the short forms of MSB and most significant bit and least significant bit. So while considering the sign of the binary value, the MSB bit is used to represent the sign. Okay, so whether that value is positive or negative. So if one bit is used to represent the sign, the other bits are used to represent the value. So here you just focus on this D3 bit. If the D3 bit is 0, then these 3 bits, or we can say that this 3 bit value is positive value. And if this D3 bit is 1, then we can say that this value is negative. Okay, 1 means negative and 0 means positive. So likewise, we will start from 0, 1, 2, 3 and up to 7, because 0 to 7 values are positive here, and I have shown here on the number line. So 0 to 7 values are positive. Now, how to represent the negative value? Okay, because this 1000, how to represent 1000 as minus 8? Because as you are going in downward direction, so here you are going to right side, right direction. Okay, so after finishing the last positive value, the value will be roll over back to minus 8. Okay, so after 7 you can't go further, so this range will be roll over back to the leftmost value. So after 7 you will get minus 8. So here 7 means what? 7 means 011. Okay, and the next value of 7 is what? 8. So this binary format is used to represent minus 8. Okay, now 1001, you are still going in downward direction. So here in this number line, you will go towards the right side always. Okay, so this 1001 means minus 7. 1010 means minus 6, and so on. So finally, the last negative value will be F, that is 1111. After 1111, you can't go further here. So you will roll back to the topmost value. So here from after 1111, you will go to the 0000. That means in the number line, 1111 is used to represent minus 1. Okay, minus 1. So in computer system also the same technique is used. Okay, so if you, whenever you type minus 1, okay, that time the computer uses all logic ones, all binary bits is equal to 1. Okay, so this is all about the unsigned binary and signed binary. Now let us see the next technique, that is subtraction using 1's complement and 2's complement. So first of all, we will see what is mean by 1's complement and what is mean by 2's complement. Now let us see the 1's complement and 2's complement in binary format, binary number system. So 1's complement means, suppose we want to perform the subtraction operation, subtraction of two values, two binary values. Okay, so in that case, what we can do, there is a way to perform the subtraction, that is called 1's complement or 2's complement. So let us see how to calculate the 1's complement of a given number. So consider the number is given 1010. Okay, so this is the number, say n1. Okay, and I want to calculate the 1's complement of this number. So what is the process? See, 1's means what? 1's complement means we have to subtract each and every digit from logic 1, so that we will get 1's complement. So 1111 minus the n1. So n1 is equal to 1010. Now what will you get here? 1010. So this is about 1's complement. 1's complement. Now let us see what is meant by 2's complement. So 2's complement means whatever you get the 1's complement, so add 1 add value 1 into the 1's complement so that we will get 2's complement. So here we have to simply add value 1 so that we will get 2's complement. 1 plus 1, 2, 2 means 0, 1. 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 and 0. So this is the value which is called 2's complement. 2's complement. Okay. So it's very simple. 1's complement means you can simply keep in mind that just inverting the given bits. Inverting the given bits, that means 1's complement. Okay. But the actual process is what? Actual process is subtract each and every digit from logic 1. That is called 1's complement. Okay. And whatever answer you will get, that will become the 1's complement. And once you add value 1 into the 1's complement, it will give you 2's complement. Okay. Now let us see some examples based on 1's complement and 2's complement. But first of all, we will see how to perform subtraction, binary subtraction, using 1's complement. Okay, it is having some rules that I want to explain to you. So consider that value 14 minus 7 we want to perform. Okay, and these values are in decimal. Okay, decimal. Now, first of all, we have to convert these values into binary. Okay, so I will write here n1 minus n2 that we have to perform. So actual process is, I will first write the actual process and after that we will solve the example. Okay, so actual process is answer is equal to n1 plus 1's complement of n2. Okay, so whatever you will perform, n1 plus 1's complement of n2, that will be the answer. But this is not the final answer. This is not the final answer. The final answer will be the condition. Again, it is having some condition. So if that condition you will meet, then and then only your process will be stopped. Okay, otherwise you have to process further. So consider that here the answer, if answer is having carry, or if the carry is generated, okay, then what you have to do? Discard the carry and add it into current answer. Okay, so that we will get the exact answer. Okay, so I will simply write here answer equal to answer plus 1. Okay, this is in symbolic fashion. If the carry is not generated, the answer is negative. Okay, so we can consider that the answer is negative because the carry is not generated. So in this case, what we have to do? Answer equal to 1's complement of answer. So that we will get the exact magnitude. Exact magnitude. Okay, so based on this, we will see one example. Okay. So consider that 14 minus 7 has to be performed using 1's complement. Okay, so what we have to do? First of all, we have to take the 1's complement of n2. Okay, so n2 is what? 7. 7 can be written in binary as 0111. So take the 2's complement of this 7, 1's of n2 is equal to what? 1000. Okay, so this is the 1's complement of n2. Now perform addition of n1 plus 1's complement of n2. So 14 in binary can be written as 1110. So this is our n1, right? Then 1's complement of n2 is what? 1000. add these values together. 0 plus 0 is 0, 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 2. 2 means what? 0, carry 1. Okay, so here if the carry is generated, here the carry is generated, so we have to discard the carry and add it into the current answer. Okay, so that we will get the exact answer. Okay, so this is our actual answer. 0111 means 7 in decimal. Okay, so 14 minus 7 is 7. Okay, now consider that if you will reverse this subtraction, then what will happen? If you will reverse this subtraction, then what will happen? 7 minus 14. So n1 will be 7 and n2 will be 14. Okay, now follow the same steps again. So n2, we have to take the 1's complement of n2. So here n2 is what? 14. 14 can be written 14 in binary as 1110. Take the 1's complement of this value 0001. Okay, we have to just invert the bits. Okay, now n1 plus 1's complement of n2 is equal to n1 is not 7, 7 means 0111. 1's complement of n2 is 0001. Okay, add these values together. 1 plus 1, 2 means 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1, 2 means carry 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1, 2 means 0, carry 1. 1 plus 0 plus 0, 1. Now, the carry is not generated here. Okay, here the carry is not generated. So, what is the next step? We have to proceed the else part. Okay, so what is written in the else part? The answer is negative. Okay, because the carry is not generated here. That means we have to again take the 1's complement of the obtained answer. Okay, so that we will get the exact magnitude of the answer. So take the 1's complement of this value. 1's of answer is equal to what? 0111. So this is what? Minus 7. Okay, actually this is the 7, but the process tells that this value is negative because we have taken 1's complement once again. Okay, now this is all about the 1's complement. So you can have this process for hexadecimal also. Okay, now let us see that same subtraction using 2's complement. Okay, so in 2's complement the process is quite different. Okay, now we will take the same examples and we will perform subtraction using 2's complement. So now n1 is already written here. N1 is what? N1 is in the first case. In this first case, n1 is equal to 14 and n2 equal to 7. Okay, so n2 is 7. Here, first of all, we have to take the 2's complement of n2. Okay. So how to take 2's complement of n2? 0111. 1's of n2 is what? 1000. If you will add 1 into this, you will get the 2's complement. 1001. So this is what? 2's of n2. Okay, add this value into n1. So 14 means 1110. Add this value into n1. So 1001. 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0, 1, 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 means 0, carry 1. So here carry is generated. So simply what we have to do? Simply we have to discard the carry and whatever bits are we are getting, that is the actual answer. This is the actual answer and the answer is positive. Okay? The answer is positive because the carry is generated. Okay? Now in the second case, considering that the result will be negative. Okay, result will be negative. So in this case, we have to simply perform the n1 and n2 values, simply reverse the n1 and n2 values so that the answer will be negative. Okay, so let us see. Now here n1 equal to 7 and n2 equal to 14. So to perform the subtraction using 2's complement, take the 2's complement of n2 first. So 1's complement of n2 is equal to what? Just invert these bits. 0001 add 1 into it. 1 plus 1 is 0, remainder one, carry 1, 1, 0, 0. So this is the 2's complement of n2. Okay. Now add this value into 7. So 0, 1, 1, 1 plus this value 0, 0, 1, 2. Okay. Now add these values together. 1, 1 plus 1, 2 means 0, 1. 1 plus 1, 2 means 0, 1, 1. Okay. Now the carry is not generated here. That means this answer is what? Negative. Okay. So to get the magnitude of this answer, we have to again take the 2's complement of this obtained answer. So how to take the 2's complement? First take the 1's complement. So 1's complement is 0, 1, 1, 0. Add 1 to this answer, you will get 1, 1, 1, 0. That means 7. So this is the 2's complement. The magnitude is negative. Sorry, the sign is negative, but the magnitude is 7. Okay, I can write here minus 7 also. Okay. So this is how we can perform subtraction of two binary values using 2's complement. Now, if you want to perform subtraction of hexadecimal values, then what will you do? Will you convert these values into binary first and then perform the 2's complement? So, no, it will become somewhat time consuming process. Okay, so what we do, we think in hexadecimal directly. So what we have done, suppose I want to perform 14 minus 7, then what we do, take 1's complement of 7. That means taking 1's complement means what? Subtracting each and every digit from 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay, so it will give you 1's complement. 1 minus 1 is 0, here 0, here 0, here is 1. So actually we are subtracting this 7 from this f value. Okay, so here I will write f minus 7. The answer will be 15 minus 7 is 8. Okay, so likewise we can think in hexadecimal directly. Okay, now 8 should be added. Sorry, 8 plus 1 will give you 2's complement. So 9 is the 2's complement of 7. Add this value into n1. Okay, so 14 plus 9, 14. Actually 14 is in decimal, so take e here. Okay, so e, that is 14 plus 9 is 23. 23 can be written in hexadecimal as 1 7. 16 1 the 16 and remainder is 7. Okay, so this is how we can write in hexadecimal also. Now suppose we have to perform 7 minus 14, so that we know that the answer will be negative. So purposely we are just trying to do that. So 7 minus 14, so take the 2's complement of 14 first. How to get 1's complement of 14? By subtracting 14 from f. E, f minus e is 15 minus 14 is 1. Add 1 into it. 1 plus 1 is 2. Add this value 2 into n1. So 7 plus 2 is 9. Now your carry is not generated, right? If the carry is not generated, then we know that the answer is negative. Okay, and to obtain the exact magnitude, actual magnitude of the answer, we have to take the 2's complement of the answer. So here take the 2's complement of 9 once again. So f minus 9, 15 minus 9 is 6. Add 1 into it. 6 plus 1 is 7. Okay, so this is the actual answer, that is minus 7. Actually 9 means minus 7, but here we have obtained the magnitude. Okay, so this is how we can perform hexadecimal subtraction also using 2's complement method. Okay, instead of using binary method, binary technique, I will recommend you to use the hexadecimal technique. Okay, for 2's complement method, so that it will save your time four times. Okay, so I hope you understood this 1's complement and 2's complement technique. Okay, thank you.